total lunar eclipse will be visible across North and South America this Sunday night.
But this one's extra special as it's a blood moon lunar eclipse. NASA's expert, Dr. Noah, is it Petro or Petro? We argued about this earlier today. And we can't hear him.
By me, I go by both.
Okay,
you
Petro.
Go by both?
Let's
okay,
go by,
right.
Let's go with Petro. We hear by Chris and you, Petro.
Thank you for joining us again, Dr. Petro. And I see you got a little Chicago swag behind you this time. You learned a little bit.
Absolutely. Well, I've got to pay homage to the great Windy City. And again, it's rolling in my education as a kid. So I'm thrilled to be with you once again today.
All right. Tell us about this lunar eclipse. First off, the question that I hate getting asked, and you probably do too, is it safe to look at?
Absolutely. You need two things to view the lunar eclipse: clear skies and clear eyes, and that's it. Unlike a solar eclipse, you don't need special glasses, and you really don't need to be any particular place at a specific instant in time. Lunar eclipses unfold very gradually. They're wonderfully slow events. So as long as you're outside anytime Sunday night and it's clear, you should be able to see this really special eclipse.
And so what's it going to look like?
So the moon will slowly pass into the Earth's shadow. So if you didn't expect that this was happening and you went out, let's say, around 9 o'clock at night, just after the sunset and the moon rose, you'd start seeing the moon get this chunk taken out of it. And gradually the moon would darken and darken until it completely passes into the Earth's shadow, and it will turn this beautiful reddish orange color, the Chicago Bears orange, peaking at around 11:11 p.m. Sunday night. And so that time of peak for about 45 minutes on the other side of it, the moon's appearance will take on this different view. You see this illustration of all of the sunrises and sunsets getting projected under the surface of the moon. So that's what makes a lunar eclipse such a special treat, is it takes on this different color.
So besides it looking different, are there any other effects of this, like maybe a gravitational effect? Does it affect your equipment? I know you have the lunar orbiter that's getting a lot of information. Do you lose it or something like that because you lose that light?
Absolutely. So when the moon goes into eclipse, the spacecraft we have orbiting the moon right now, the Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter, goes into darkness as well. We use the sun to power our spacecraft, to charge our batteries. When the sun goes away, we lose our power source. So we have to turn all of our instruments off and basically fly through the eclipse on as little power as possible to preserve our batteries. What also happens to spacecraft is we lose our main source of heat, the sun. And so what we'll do is preheat the spacecraft to get it warm so that we stay above our limits. An important part of that is that the moon also cools off. You know, the moon is sitting there in deep space. It's, a beautiful, always a sunny day on the moon when the sun is up. But all of a sudden, the sun is going to go away. And so what happens then is that the surface of the moon cools very quickly. And so there's a very interesting thermal effect on the surface of the moon during an eclipse as well. So there's a very direct change that occurs, just like on a hot day, as I know you had in Chicago today, when a cloud goes over, all of a sudden, oh, it feels really nice and things cool down. Well, on the moon, there's no atmosphere, but boy, that surface cools down really quickly when the sun goes away.
So if we were up on the moon when this happened, how big of a temperature drop would it be?
You'd feel, well, if you were on the moon, hopefully you're in a spacesuit that's climate controlled and can handle it. But the surface will cool down rapidly, about 100 degrees Fahrenheit, wow, in the span of a very short period of time. I liken to taking something straight out of the oven and putting it into a freezer, or all those videos that I'm sure you're familiar with on very cold winter days when people take boiling pans of water and throw it in the air and it freezes.
Throw it up in the water.
Now that's effectively what's going on like the surface of the moon during
maybe 50, 60 years from now, there'll be a local news segment where this happens on the moon and
yes,
we go out, send the weather guy out to throw the water up in the air and show how quickly it freezes, right?
Absolutely. It'd be a great experiment. So I'm going to nominate you for that experiment.
There you go.
And,
well,
starting in 2025,
camp, so
we'll be able to do it.
Yeah. Demetrius and I have been to space camp.
We've been to
space totally
camp,
qualified.
So, yeah, we are very much qualified.
Yeah.
So
thank you so much, Noah Petro. We appreciate
thank
you joining
you very
us.
Very much. Send us Boeing back, okay?
Absolutely.
I know you're in Alexandria.
You can always find more on NASA's social media pages and check out